There's something about the folk music tradition that makes a man want to write a song about his childhood and how different things are today. When I was a boy, I heard a lot of men singing about trains, about how they grew up with trains, but now the trains were all gone. Can't write a song about that, because when I was a boy, trains were all gone. And what we had was a television set. And for years and years, during at least one show every night, the television set would show us a man putting A1 steak sauce on his hamburger. Now, his friends and family were shocked and outraged at this. But the man spoke up. He asked them a simple question. He said, "What is a hamburger? Chopped ham?" They laughed nervously, but he had a point to make, and he pressed on. "It's chopped steak," he said, gently smiling. "And what's better on steak than A1? Well, by the end of the commercial, his quiet wisdom had won them over. And they were all putting A1 steak sauce on their hamburgers. The problem with this is that, away from the television, I rarely saw anyone putting A1 steak sauce on their hamburger. Almost no one did it twice. I did it once. It tasted like burnt shoes, and I went back to using ketchup. At some point, later in life, I thought to myself, those guys wasted millions of dollars trying to get America to put A1 on their hamburgers instead of ketchup. But nobody does. What a fail. But then it occurred to me, that wasn't really the point, was it? I realized that, without ever questioning it, I had somehow grown up believing that there isn't anything better on steak than A1. And that's not true. They never made that claim, but they were lying in how they framed the question. With enough repetition, they put a constant in my head in place of a variable, an absolute where there should have been a free and informed choice. So I guess what I miss about my childhood is how, when the commercials were over, that kind of thing stopped. Walter Cronkite would come on and tell us the president's men had broken the law and show us caskets coming home from a war we'd run out of good reasons for fighting.
Some mighty wheels are spinning along the southbound track. One train is coming back now. Every patriot must act and get on board the endless corporate think tank infotainment hearts and minds campaign. The engine makes loud and frightening noises. The best way to drown individual voices. Make us all fight over engineered choices. Point our fingers, misassign the blame. Everybody ride the train. The TV screens will prevent any stray thoughts. Conductors provide complimentary steak sauce for your brain. On the bullshit train. Everybody's riding the bullshit train.